On Monday, Prime Minister Modi was given the first ever Philip Kotler Presidential Award, named after the management guru and professor Philip Kotler. The news was shared with great excitement by many Union Cabinet ministers and BJP chief ministers, but they failed to answer one question. What exactly is it? We at The Wire began to investigate, and we've been left with five questions about Prime Minister Modi's new prize. Question 1. Who chose Prime Minister Modi as the first ever winner of this award? The award citation praised Modi's outstanding leadership for the nation and many of his flagship projects, but it said nothing about the distinguished professor choosing him. In fact, it said nothing at all about any jury members or about the organization that was giving the award. It was only after The Wire's report questioning the origins of the prize went viral that Professor Kotler said anything at all. First, he tweeted to endorse it, and then he told reporters that he had been the one to choose the Prime Minister. Question 2. Why did Philip Kotler only endorse the award 24 hours after it was presented? Narendra Modi received the prize on Monday afternoon at the Prime Minister's residence, 7 Lok Kalyan Marg. It was handed over by Jagdish Sheth, a friend of Philip Kotler's, and Tosif Zia Siddiqui, who organized the Indian edition of Kotler's World Media Summit last month in New Delhi. But the website of the World Marketing Summit International makes no mention of the existence of this award or of Kotler's decision to give it to the Indian Prime Minister. Neither does Kotler's personal website. Question 3. Kotler gave permission to an Indian team to use his name on awards, provided there was a robust assessment framework. Did that happen? The World Marketing Summit India took place in New Delhi's Aero City in December of 2018. A number of marketing excellence prizes, with Philip Kotler's name on them, were given to Indian companies. But members of the judging committee for these awards told The Wire that they were never approached to do any judging. But many of the winners were the event's own partners and sponsors, including Baba Ramdev's Patanjali Group, the content firm Witty Feed, and the public sector undertaking Gale India. Tosif Zia Siddiqui, who organized the Indian edition of Kotler's World Marketing Summit and handed the presidential prize to Modi this week, described himself as Kotler's representative. Why has he gone quiet? After The Wire's first article investigating the prize, the website for the World Media Summit India got taken down. So did its Twitter handle, and so did the website of Siddiqui's own firm, Suslens Research. Siddiqui is based in Dammam in Saudi Arabia. We wanted to learn more about him, so we accessed his LinkedIn profile, in which he says that he's employed by SABIC, the Saudi Arabian state-owned petrochemical company. It is unknown whether SABIC authorized him to plan the marketing summit or to present the presidential award to Prime Minister Modi. After our second article referring to Siddiqui's LinkedIn account, his LinkedIn account was also deleted. Question 5. Is it part of the robust assessment framework that Siddiqui is employed by a foreign firm which is looking to acquire a large stake in an Indian public sector company? If it's true that Siddiqui is an employee of SABIC, as his online profile claims, that raises bigger questions. SABIC is reportedly planning to purchase a huge stake in the Indian public sector company OPAL, the ONGC Petro Editions Limited. OPAL is co-promoted by ONGC and Gale India. And Gale India is one of the companies that sponsored Siddiqui's summit. It also received one of his prizes. These are questions that deserve to be asked and answered. If the Prime Minister of India is publicizing an award he received from a man employed by a foreign firm with interests in India's energy industry, that's something Indian citizens deserve to know.
To receive instant updates on all videos from The Wire, click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. Pay to support independent journalism. Click the link in the description and choose the amount you want to pay.